odd. Skin was pale, his eye was odd. He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again.
He trod a path that few have trod, did Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
He kept a shop in London town, of fancy clients and good renown. And what if none of their souls were saved? They went to their maker impeccably shaved. By Sweeney, by Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. Sweeney.
A bow and a fancy chair.
A mug of salt and a leather strop, an apron, a towel, a pail, and a mop.
For neat this he deserves a nod, the Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. Inconspicuous Sweeney was, quick and quiet and clean he was. Back of his smile, under his word, Sweeney heard music that nobody heard. Sweeney!
Sweeney was smooth, Sweeney was subtle, Sweeney would blink and wrap his skull. Sweeney was conspicuous, Sweeney was subtle, Sweeney would bark and wrap his skull. Inconspicuous Sweeney was, Sweeney was, Sweeney was, Sweeney was, Sweeney was, Sweeney was, Sweeney, Sweeney, Sweeney.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
He served a dark and eventual god.
He served a dark and eventual god.
What happened then? Well, that's a play, and he wouldn't want us to give it away. Not Sweeney.
Not Sweeney Todd.
The demon power of Fleet Street.
Beheld its wonders, from the Dardanelles to the mountains of Peru. But there's no place like London. I feel home again. I can hear the city bells ring, whatever I will do. No, there's no place like London.
Mr. Todd, sir.
You are young. Life has been kind to you. You will learn.
It is here we go our several ways. Farewell, Anthony. I won't soon forget the good ship Bountiful, nor the young man who saved my life.
It would have been a poor Christian indeed who spotted you pitching and tossing on that raft and not sounded the alarm.
There's many a Christian who would have done just that and not lost a wink's sleep for it either.
Arms, arms for a miserable woman on a miserable chilly morning. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
How would you like a little kiss, dear? A little jig jig, a little bounce around the bush. Wouldn't you like to push me past the? It looks to me, dear, like you've got plenty there to push.
Arms, arms for a pitiful woman
you glare at me, woman? Off, I say!
Then how would you like a little kiss, dear? We'll go jig jig a little...
Off, I say! To the devil with you!
Arms, arms for a pitiful woman.
Pardon me, sir, but there's no need to fear the likes of her. She was only a half-crazed beggar woman. London's full of them.
I beg your indulgence, boy. My mind is far from easy. For on these once familiar streets, I feel the chill of ghostly shadows everywhere. Forgive me.
There's nothing to forgive.
Farewell.
Mr. Todd, before we part...
What is it?
I've honored my promise never to question you. Whatever brought you to that sorry shipwreck is your affair. And yet, over the many months of our journey home, I've come to think of you as a friend. And if trouble lies ahead of you in London, if you need help or money...
No! There's a hole in the world like a great black pit in the vermin of the world inhabit it, and its morals aren't worth what a pig could spit, and that goes by the name of London. At the top of the hole sit a privileged few, making mock of the vermin in the lower zoo, turning beauty into filth and greed. I too have sailed the world and seen its wonders, for the cruelty of men is as wondrous as Peru, but there's no place like London. And his wife, and she was beautiful. A foolish barber and his wife, she was his reason and his life, and she was beautiful, and she was virtuous, and he was naive. There was another man who saw that she was beautiful, a pious vulture of the law, who with a gesture of his claw removed the barber from his plate. Then there was nothing but to wait, and she would fall, so soft, so young, so lost, and oh, so beautiful.
And the lady, sir, did she succumb?
Oh, that was many years ago. I doubt if anyone would know.
Now leave me, Anthony, I beg of you. For there is somewhere I must go, something I must find out. Now and alone. But surely we'll meet again before I'm off to Plymouth.
If you want, you may well find me. Or on Fleet Street, I shouldn't wonder.
Well, until then, Mr. Todd, farewell.
There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it, and its morals aren't worth what a pig could spit.
She was a ghost half a minute. Can't you sit you down, sit. All I meant is that I haven't seen a customer for weeks. Did you come in for a pie, sir?
Do forgive me if me head's a little fight. Ugh, what is that? But you think we had the plague? From the way that people keep avoiding now you don't. Heaven knows I try, sir. Ugh, but there's no one comes in even to inhale. Right you are, sir, would you like a drop of ale? Mind you, I can't hardly blame them. These are probably the worst boys in London. Only Lord in nothing more, is that just disgusting? You'll have to concede it lies in London. Even that's polite, the worst boys in London. If you doubt it, take a bite. Is that just disgusting? You'll have to concede it. It's nothing but crusting. You drink this, you'll need it. The worst boys in London. And no wonder with the price of meat what it is. When you get it, never thought I'd live to see the day. Many think it was a treat, bunny poor animals. What are dying in the street? Mrs. Mooney has a pie shop. Does a business, but I know it's something weird. Lately our neighbour's cats have disappeared. I have to hand it to her, what I call enterprise. Popping pussies in the pies, wouldn't do in my shop. Just the thought of it's enough to make you sick. And I'm telling you, them pussy cats is quick. No denying times is hard, sir. Even harder than the worst pies in London. Only Lord and nothing more is that just revolting, all greasy and gritty. It looks like it's molting and tastes like, well, pity a woman alone. With limited wind and the worst boys in London. Oh, sir, times is hard. Times is hard.
Spit it out, dear. Go on the floor. There's worse things than that down there. That's my boy.
Isn't that a room up there over the shop? If times are so hard, why don't you rent it out? Should bring in something.
Up there? Oh, no one to go near it. People think it's haunted. You see, years ago, something happened up there. Something not very nice. There was a barber and his wife, and he was beautiful. A proper artist with a knife, but they transported him for life, and he was beautiful. Barker, his name was Benjamin Barker.
Transported, you say? What was his crime?
Foolishness. He had this wife, you see. Pretty little thing, silly little nit, had a chance for the world on a string. Poor thing, poor thing. There were these two, you see. Wanted a like mad, one among the judge, other one his beadle. Every day they'd nudge and they'd wheedle. Still she wouldn't budge from her needle. Too bad, pure thing. So they merely shipped that poor blighter off south, they did, leaving her with nothing but grief and a year-old kid. Did she use her head even then? Oh no, God forbid. Poor fool. Ah, but there was worse yet to come. Poor thing. Joanna, that was the baby's name. Pretty little Joanna.
Go on.
My, you do like a good story, don't you? Well, Beadle calls on her all polite. Poor thing, poor thing. The judge, he tells her, is all contrite. He blames himself for her dreadful plight. She must come straight to his house tonight. Poor thing, poor thing.
Thank you.
Of course, when she goes there, poor thing, they're having this ball all in masks. There's no one she knows there, poor dear, poor thing. She wanders tormented and drinks, poor thing. The judge has repented, she thinks, poor thing. Oh, where is Judge Turpin, she asks. He was there all right, only not so contrite. She wasn't no match for such craft, you see, and everyone thought it so droll. They figured she'd have to be daft, you see, so all of them stood there and laughed, you see. Poor soul, poor thing.
No! Would no one have mercy on her?
So it is you, Benjamin Barker.
Not Barker. Not Barker. Todd now. Sweeney Todd. Where is she?
Good God. What did they do to you down there in bloody Australia, however?
Where is my wife? Where is Lucy?
She poisoned herself. Arsenic from the apothecary on the corner. I tried to stop her, but she wouldn't listen to me.
And my daughter?
Joanna? He's got her.
He, Judge Turpin?
Even he had a conscience tucked away, I suppose. Adopted her like his own. You could say it was good luck for her. Almost.
15 years. Sweating in a living hell on a trumped-up charge. 15 years dreaming that I might come home to a loving wife and child. Let them quake in their boots! Judge Turpin and the beetle! For their hour has come.
What? You going to get him? You, a bleeding little nobody of a runaway convict. Don't make me laugh. You'll never get his Iron Mightiness, nor the beadle neither. Not in a million years. You got any money? Listen to me. You got any money?
No money.
Then how are you going to live, even?
I'll live. If I have to sweat in the sewers or in a plague hospital, I'll live, and I will have them.
Oh, you poor thing, you poor thing. Wait. See? It don't have to be the sewers or the plague hospital. When they come for the girl, I hid him. I thought, who knows? Maybe the poor silly blight will be back again someday and need him. Cracked in the head, wasn't I? Times as bad as they are, I could have gotten 5, maybe 10 quid for him any day. You see, you can be a barber again. My, the mandals has chased silver, ain't they?
Silver, yes. These are my friends. See how they glisten. See this one shine, how he smiles in the light. My friends, my faithful friends, speak to me, friends, whisper and listen. I know, you've been locked out of sight all these years. Like me, my friends, well, I've come home to find you waiting. Won't we?
I'm your friend too.
Come, let me hold you.
If you only knew,
now,
Mr. Todd,
with a sigh,
ooh, Mr. Todd,
you grow warm in my hands, my friends,
oh,
my clever friends.
Oh, I had a fondness for you, I did.
Rest now, my friend.
Never you fear,
soon
Mr. Todd.
Fold you.
You can move in
soon
here, Mr. Todd.
No splendors you never have dreamed all your days. Complete again!
Civilized men behave, he never forgot and he never forgave. Not Sweeney, not Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
Bert!
Bert!
Hey, you there, how about a bird for the missus? Bert! Bert!
And how are they today?
Oh, hungry as always, Miss Joanna.
Green finch and linnet bird, nightingale, blackbird, how is it you see? Sitting in cages, never taking breath. Outside the sky, waves beckoning, beckoning, just beyond the bars. How can you remain staring at the rain, maddened by the stars? How is it you see? Is it you sing? Green finch and linnet bird, nightingale, blackbird, teach me how to sing. Whence comes this melody constantly flowing? Is it rejoicing or merely hallowing? Are you discussing or fussing or simply dreaming? Singing to be sold. Have you decided it's safer in cages, singing when you're tall? My cage has many rooms, damask and dark. Nothing there sings, not even my lock. Locks never really know when they're captive. Teach me to be
Oh.
Lord, teach me how to sing. If I cannot fly, let me sing.
I have sailed the world, beheld its wonders, from the pearls of Spain to the rubies of Tibet, but not even in London have I seen such a wonder. Lady, look at me, miss, oh, look at me, please, oh, favor me with your glance. Ah, miss, what do you see off there in those trees? Oh, won't you give me a chance? Who would sail to Spain for all its wonders, when in Curie's Lane lies the greatest wonder yet? Ah, miss, look at you, pale and ivory-skinned, oh, look at you, looking so sad, so queer. Promise not to retreat to the darkness back of your window, not to you, not to you, look down here, look at me.
Teach me how to sing. If I cannot fly, let me sing. Arms, arms for a miserable woman. Beg your pardon, it's you, sir. Thank you kindly.
One moment, mother. Perhaps he knows house that is.
That's the great Judge Turpin's house, that is.
And the young lady who resides there.
That's Joanna, his pretty little ward. Oh, no, but don't you go trespassing there, young man. Not if you value your hide. Tamper there, and it's a good whipping for you. Or any other youth with mischief on his mind. Hey, boy, sailor boy, one at Snuggly Harbour, up in me gate for Docket Street, I see it list to starboard.
Take it, off, I say. Which one sings the sweetest?
All's the same, sir, sixpence and cheaper the price.
He sings bravely, but why does he batter his wings so wildly against the cage?
We blind them, that's what he does. And not telling night from day, they sing and sing. Oh, pray, you little creatures. Have pleasures of the bird, sir.
I feel you, Johanna. I feel you. I was half convinced I'd waken, satisfied enough to dream you. Happily I was mistaken, Johanna. I'll steal you, Johanna. I'll steal you.
Johanna! Johanna!
Oh dear!
If I am to see your face again on this or any other neighbor street, you'll rue the day you were born. Is that plain enough speaking
but
for
sir,
you?
But sir, I beg of you, there is nothing in my heart but the most sincere sentiments.
Dispose of him!
Oh dear, I knew!
You hurt his worship?
But, friend, I have no fight with you.
Get the gist, friend? Next time it'll be your neck.
Johanna, if I were to think you encouraged that young rogue...
Oh, but father, I hope always to be obedient to your command.
Dear child, how sweet you look in that light muslin gown.
I'll steal you, Joanna. I'll steal you. Do they think that walls can hide you? Even now I'm at your window. I am in the dark beside you, sweetly buried in your yellow hair. I feel you, Johanna, and one day I'll steal you. Till I'm with you, then I'm with you there, sweetly buried in your yellow hair.
That's him over there.
Yes, dear. He's always Hair Thursdays.
Haircutter, barber, and tooth puller to His Royal Majesty the King of Naples.
Oh, Italian, all the rage he is.
Not for long.
Oh, Mr. T, you really think you can do it?
By tomorrow, they'll be flocking after me like sheep to be shorn.
Oh, no. It's the Beadle. Beadle Bamford.
So much the better.
But what if he recognizes you? Hadn't we better...
I will do what I have set out to do, woman.
Sorry, dear, I'm sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Do you wake every morning in shame and despair to discover your pillow is covered with hair? Why not to be there? Well, ladies and gentlemen, from now on you can wait in a daze. You need never again need to worry nor care. I will show you a miracle marvelous rare. Gentlemen, you are about to see something that rose from the dead. On the top of me, Ed. Was Pirelli's Miracle Elixir. That's what did the trick, sir, true, sir, true. Was it quick, sir, did it in a tick, sir, just like an elixir ought to do. How about a bottle, mister? Only cost a penny, guaranteed.
Penny buys a bottle, I don't know.
Penny for a bottle, is it?
Let's go.
Pirelli stimulate the growth, sir. You can have me, oh, sir, tis unique. Rub a minute, stimulate it in it. Soon you'll have to thin it once a week. Penny buys a bottle, guaranteed.
Penny buys a bottle, might as well.
Have you ever smelled the cleanest smell?
Does it
gently dab it, gets to be an habit. Soon there'll be enough, sir, somebody can grab it. See that chap with hair like Shelley's? You can tell he's used for rallies.
Let me buy a bottle,
make that too.
Pardon me, ma'am, more saddle.
Well,
Pirelli's well Anastacia Fixer. You can have your pics of the girls. Buy her at least, use a bottle of it. Ladies seem to love it.
What is this?
Wanna buy
what
a bottle?
Smells like piss.
Only has a penny guarantee.
Looks like piss. This is piss. Piss with it.
Let me smell that bottle. I want to drink this. What is this?
Man, this stuff.
Give us back our money.
Back to you, ma'am.
Where is Pirelli?
Yeah, where is Pirelli?
Pirelli's activate your roots, sir.
Keep it off your boots, sir. Eats right.
Go get Pirelli.
Get Pirelli's. Use a bottle of it. Ladies seem to love it.
Flies do too.
Grow a little wixer, then some buzz. The Pirelli's will make it thicker, like a good elixir always does. Trust Pirelli's if you're a sixer. Fix an elixir, don't look grim. Just Pirelli's miracle elixir, that'll trick sir.
What about the money?
If you've got a kickster,
what about the money? Where's Pirelli? Go get Pirelli!
Pirelli, the king of the Barbara kings, a buongiorno, good day. I blow you a kiss. And I, the so famous Pirelli, I wish you to know who has the nerve to say my elixir is piss. Who says this?
I do. My name is Mr. Sweeney Todd, and I've opened a bottle of Pirelli's elixir. And I say to you, it is no more than an arrant fraud, concocted of piss and ink.
Phew, he's right. Better to throw your money down the sewer.
Never mind that madman who's up first for a magnificent shave.
And furthermore, I have serviced no kings, yet I wager I can shave a cheek with 10 times the dexterity than any street mountebank. You see these razors?
The finest in England.
I lay them against £5. You're no match for me. You hear me, sir? Either accept my challenge or reveal yourself a sham.
Bravo, bravo.
These are indeed a fine razors. Instruments like this once seen cannot soon be forgotten. You wager this against £5, sir?
I do.
You hear this foolish man. Watch and he see how he will soon regret his folly.
Friends, neighbors, who's for a free shave?
Oh, me, Mr. Thompson!
Bring the basins, bring the towels.
Over here, bring me a chair. Will Beadle Bamford be the judge?
Glad as always to oblige my friends and neighbors. I'll put that there.
Somebody get me a chair.
I got it, sir.
Ready!
Ready.
The fastest, smoothest shave is the winner.
Signori, we mix the lathered, but first you gather around. Signori, you're looking a man who've had the glory to shave with a poor Mr. Sweeney. Whoever, I beg your pardon, will probably say it was only gun or not. It was a the pop! To shave the face. To pull a toot require the grace and not the brute. For if you slip, you nick the skin, you clip the chin, you reap the leap, a beat, and that's the truth. To shave the face or even a part without the smart require the heart. It's take the art. I show you a chart. I started a study in my youth.
to cut the hair, to trim a day beard, to make a day bristle, clean like a whistle. This from the early infancy, the talent give to me, by God. It take a day skill, it take a day brains, it take a day will, to take a day pains, it take a day piss, it take a day grace.
The winner is Todd.
Smooth as a baby's bottom.
Sir, I bow to his skill, a far a defter than my own.
The 5 pounds?
Here, sir. May the good Lord smile upon you. Until we meet again, Mr. Todd. Come, boy! Signori, signori, bellissima, signori, buongiorno, buongiorno a tutti. Ciao.
Who'd have thought it, dear? You pulled it off.
Oh, sir, Mr. Todd, sir. Do you have an establishment of your own?
He certainly does. Sweeney Todd's Tonsorial Parlor above my meat pie shop on Fleet Street.
Mr. Todd? Strange, sir, but your face seems known to me.
Him? That's a laugh. Him being my uncle's cousin and just arrived from Birmingham yesterday.
And yet, already I've heard Beadle Bamford spoken of with such great respect.
Well, sir, I try my best for my neighbours. Fleet Street, above your pie shop, ma'am?
That's it, sir.
Well, then, you will surely see me there before the week is out.
You will be welcome, Beadle Bamford, and I guarantee to give you, without a penny's charge, the closest shave you've ever known.
Sweeney planned like a perfect machine. He planned
barbing the hook,
baiting the trap,
set a sort of a scene. He did laying the trail, showing the traces, and letting it lead to higher places.
Laying the trail, showing the traces, letting it lead to higher places. Slyly trotted and Sweeney did exactly like a machine. A sort of a scene.
Times have I told you, I'll not have trash from the gutter hanging around my establishment.
Not just a penny, dear. Or a pie. One of them pies that give the stomach crumbs to half the neighborhood. Oh, come on, dear. Have a heart, dear.
Off with you, or you'll get a kick on the rump that'll make your teeth chatter.
Stuck up thing, you and your fancy airs. Alms, alms for a desperate woman.
It's not much of a chair, but it'll do to get your fancy new one. It was me poor Albert's chair, it was. Sat in it all day long after his leg gave out from the dropsy. Kind of bare, isn't it? I never did like a bare room. Oh, well, we'll find some nice little knickknacks.
Why doesn't the beadle come before the week is out? That is what he said.
And who says the week is out yet? It's only Tuesday.
Ah.
Easy now, hush, love, hush. Don't distress yourself, what's your rush? Keep your thoughts nice and lush. Wait. Hush, love, hush. Think it through.
Once it bubbles, then what's to do? Watch it close, let it brew. Wait, I've been thinking flowers, maybe daisies, to brighten up the room. Don't you think some flowers, pretty daisies, might relieve the gloom? I'll wait, love, wait.
And the judge, when will I get to him?
Can't you think of nothing else? Always brooding away on your wrongs. What happened to heaven knows how many years ago?
Yeah.
Love's slow, time so fast. Now goes quickly, see now it's past. Soon will come, soon will last. Wait. Don't you know, silly man, half the fun is to plan the plan. All good things come to those who can. Wait. Giddy flowers maybe, instead of daisies. I don't know though, what do you think?
Yes.
Giddy flowers, I'd say. Nothing like a nice bowl of gillies.
Mr. Todd!
Anthony!
I've paced Fleet Street a dozen times with no success, but now the sign. In business already.
Yes.
I congratulate you and,
Mrs. Lovett, sir.
A pleasure, ma'am. Oh, Mr. Todd, I have so much to tell you. I found the fairest and most loving maid that any man can dream of. And yet, there's problems. She has a guardian that's so tyrannical she's kept shut up from the human eye. But just this morning, this key fell from a shuttered window. The surest sign that Joanna loves me. And...
Joanna?
Oh, that's a name, ma'am, and turpin of the abominable parent. A judge, it seems, but a monstrous tyrant nonetheless. Oh, Mr. Todd, once the judge goes to court, I'll slip in and plead with her to fly with me tonight. Yet, when I have her, where can I bring her until I've hired a coach to race us home to Plymouth? Oh, Mr. Todd, if I could just lodge her here for an hour or so.
Bring her, dear.
You mean it, ma'am? And... I have your consent, Mr. Todd.
The girl may come.
Oh, thank you, thank you. For now, I must hurry, for surely the judge is off to Old Bailey. A thousand blessings to you both.
Joanna, who'd have thought it, dear? It's like fight, isn't it? You'll have her back in your arms before the day is out.
For only a few hours, before he takes her away to the other side of England.
Oh, that sailor. Let him bring her here, and then since it's so hot for a little, that's a throat to slit, dear. Oh, we'll make a lovely home for her. You and me, the poor thing. All those years without a scrap of motherly affection. I'll soon change that, I will. For if ever there was a maternal heart, it's mine.
Good morning, Mr. Todd. And to you, bellissima signorina.
Well, how do you do, signor? I'm
sure. Business with Mr. Todd. Perhaps if you'll give me the permission.
Yes, indeed. I'll just pop on down to me pies. Oh, locks. Look at it now. It don't look like it's had a kind word since 11:30. What would you say, son, to a nice juicy meat pie? Your teeth are strong, I hope.
Yes, Mum.
Then come with me, love.
Mr. Todd.
Signor Pirelli.
Call me Danny. Danny O'Higgins, the name when it's not professional. It's not much, but I imagine you'd tidied up a bit, huh? I'd like me £5 back, if you don't mind.
Why?
That's it, love. Tuck in.
Ah. Well, it'll hold me over till your customers start coming. Then it's half your profits you'll hand over to me every week on a Friday. Share and share alike. All right, Mr. Benjamin Barker.
Why do you call me that?
At least you got a nice head of hair on you.
Well, to tell the truth, Mum, it gets off a lot.
You don't remember me. Why should you? I was just
A down-and-out Irish lad you hired for a couple of weeks, you know, sweeping up hair and such like. But I remember these. And you. Benjamin Barker, later transported to Botany Bay for life. So, Mr. Todd, is it a deal, or do I run down the street for me pal, Beetle Bamford? You think you smart? You foolish boy. Tomorrow you start in my employ. You understand? You like my plan?
Oh God, he's got an appointment with his tailor. If he's late, it's my fault. You don't know him.
I wouldn't want to, dear, I'm sure.
Oh, me wig. Signor, it's late. I reminded you, the tailor. Oh. He ain't here.
Signor Pirelli has been called away.
Where did he go?
He didn't say. You better run after him.
Oh, no, sir. Without orders to the contrary, I'd best wait for him here.
So, Mrs. Lovett gave you a meat pie, did she?
Oh, yes, sir. She's a real kind lady.
Oh, a whole meat pie? Well, that's a treat. And yet, if I know a growing boy, there's probably still room for more, eh?
Oh, yes, sir. An aching void.
Then why don't you go downstairs and wait for your master there? There'll be another meat pie in it for you, I'm sure. And tell Mrs. Lovett I said to give you a nice big tot of gin.
Gin, sir! Sir, thank you kindly! Gin, you're a Christian indeed! Mom, the gentleman upstairs, Ted, told me to get me a nice tot of gin!
Gin, dear? Why not?
His hands were quick, his fingers strong. It stung a little, but not for long.
Those who thought I'm a simple bud were soon reconsidering under the sod.
Consigned there with a friendly prod
from Sweeney Todd.
The demon barber of Fleet Street.
See your razor gleam, Sweeney. Feel how well it fits, how well it fits. It floats across the throats of hypocrites.
This is the fourth time, sir, that you have been brought before this bench. Though it is my earnest wish ever to temper justice with mercy, your persistent dedication to a life of crime is such an abomination before God and man that I have no alternative but to sentence you to hang by the neck until you are dead. Court adjourned. It is perhaps remiss of me to close the court so early, but the stench of those miserable wretches at the bar was so offensive to my nostrils that I feared my eagerness for fresher air might well impair the soundness of my judgment.
Well, sir, the adjournment is fortunate for me, sir, for it's today we celebrate my sweet little Annie's birthday. And to have her daddy home so soon to hug her and kiss her will be her crowning joy on such a happy day.
It is a happy moment for me, too. Walk with me, for I have news for you. In order to shield her from the evils of this world, I have decided to marry Joanna next Monday.
Oh, sir, happy news indeed.
Strange. When I offered myself to her, she showed a certain reluctance. But that's natural enough in a young girl. Now that she has had time for reflection, I am sure she will greet my proposal in a more sensible frame of mind.
He means to marry me Monday. What shall I do? I'd rather
die. I have a plan.
I'll swallow poison on Sunday. That's what I'll do. I'll get the
I have a plan.
What was that, a noise?
A plan.
I think I heard a noise.
A plan.
Couldn't be. He's in court. He's in court today. Still, that was a noise. Wasn't that a noise? You must have heard that.
Kiss me.
Oh, sir.
Oh, miss.
Oh, sir. If he should marry me Monday, what shall I do? I'd die
afraid. We fly tonight.
Tis Friday, virtually Sunday. What can we do with time so free?
We fly tonight.
Behind the curtain, quick.
Tonight.
I think I heard a click.
Tonight.
It was a gate, it's a gate.
It's not a gate. There's no gate. You don't have a gate. If you'd only listen, miss. Kiss me.
Tonight.
Kiss me.
You mean tonight.
Kiss me.
Oh, sir.
Kiss me.
I feel afraid.
Be not afraid tonight. Marry on Monday, that's what you'll do.
And gladly,
and
sir,
noon.
I knew I'd be with you one day, even not knowing who you were.
Miss Mary,
have you
Mary,
never
Mary,
come?
Mary,
that you can
Monday,
call the
baby?
That you can
kill
the hand? We're in
tennis,
you'll tremble
Mary,
by
Mary,
a horse,
come
to see again, and rest of it, kiss me.
Of course.
Kiss me.
You're sure?
Kiss me.
I shall.
Kiss me, oh, sir.
Yes, yes, but surely the respect she owes me as her guardian should be sufficient to kindle a more tender emotion.
Excuse me, my lord. May I request my lord permission, my lord, to speak? Forgive me if I suggest, my lord, you're looking less than your best, my lord. There's powder upon your vest, my lord, and stubble upon your cheek. And ladies, my lord, are weak.
Perhaps if she greet me cordially upon my return, I should give her a small gift.
Ladies in their sensitivities, my lord, have a fragile sensibility. When a girl's emergent, probably it's urgent, you defer to her gentility, my lord. Personal disorder cannot be ignored, given their genteel proclivities. Meaning no offense, it happens they resent it, ladies in their sensitivities, my lord.
Stubble, you say? Perhaps I am a little over hasty with my morning ablutions.
Fret not though, my lord, I know a place, my lord, a barber, my lord, of skill. Thus armed with a shaven face, my lord, some eau de cologne to brace, my lord, and musk to enhance the chase, my lord, he'll dazzle the girl until she bows to your every will.
That may well be so.
Here we are, sir. I bid you good day.
Good day. And where is this miraculous barber?
In Fleet Street, sir.
Perhaps you may be right. Take me to him.
The name is Todd.
We best not wait until Monday.
Sir, concur in full.
It isn't right. We best be married on Sunday.
Saturday, sir, would also
or
do.
Or else tonight.
Oh dear, I heard a noise. I mean another noise.
Like what?
Never mind, just a noise. Just another
mind.
Noise.
Just another noise. Something in the street.
Just
another kiss me.
Oh, sir.
We'll go to Paris on Monday.
What shall I wear? I dare
we'll ride a train.
With you beside me on Sunday. What will I care what things
then sail to Spain.
I'll take my reticule, reticule. I need my reticule.
We'll buy a reticule.
Listen, and never think you're a fool, but reticule. Never leave my side. It's the only thing my mother gave me.
Kiss me.
Kiss me.
My mom, please, we can go tonight.
Run along, dear.
Oh, no, Mom. I daren't budge till he calls for me.
I'll pop up and see what Mr. Todd says. Oh, me poor knees is not what they was, dear. How long before the Italian gets back?
He won't be back.
Oh, Mr. T. You didn't. You're crazy mad. What, killing a man that done you no harm? And the boy downstairs?
He recognized me from the old days. He tried to blackmail me. Have my profits forever.
That's a different matter, then. What a relief, dear. For a moment there, I thought you lost your marbles. Oh, that blood. Enough to make you come all over's goose flesh, ain't it? Poor bugger. Oh, well. Ooh, £3. Well, waste not, want not. That's what I always say. Now, dear, we've got to use the old noggin.
There we are, sir, above the pie shop, sir.
Thank you. You may leave me now.
Thank you, sir, thank you.
Well, first there's the lad.
Bring him up here.
Him too? Now, surely one's enough for today, Mr. T. Shouldn't indulge yourself, you know. Let me see. He's halfsies over already with the gin.
Oh, Providence is kind.
Who is it?
Judge Turpin.
Him? Him? The judge? It can't be.
Quickly, leave me.
What are you going to do?
Leave me, I said.
Don't worry, dear. I'm out. Excuse me, Your Excellence.
Mr. Todd?
At your service, sir. An honor to receive your patronage.
Now, dear, it seems your governor's left you high and dry. But don't worry. Your Aunt Nellie will think of what to do with you. Here, come into me lovely back parlor.
These premises are hardly prepossessing. And yet the beadle tells me you're the most accomplished of the barbers in the city.
Oh, well, that is gracious of him. And you must excuse the modesty of my establishment. It has been a few days since I have set up shop here, and some necessaries are yet to come. Sit, sir, if you will, sir. Sit. And what may I do for you today, sir? A stylish trimming of the hair? A soothing skin massage?
You see, sir, a man infatuate with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and pomace stone and lend me a more seductive tone, a sprinkling perhaps of French cologne, but first, sir, I think, a shave.
The closest I ever gave.
Bum 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 bum.
You're in a merry mood today, Mr. Todd.
Tis your delight, sir, catching fire from one man to the next.
Tis true, sir, love can still inspire the blood to pound the heart leap higher.
What more can man require
than love, sir?
More than love, sir.
What, sir?
Women.
Ah, yes, women.
Pretty women.
Bum 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 bum.
Now then, my friend. Now to your purpose, patience, enjoy it. Revenge can't be taken in.
Make haste, and if we wed, you'll be commanded, sir.
My lord. And who may be said is your intended, sir?
My ward, and pretty as a rosebud.
She is her mother.
What was that?
Nothing, sir, nothing. May we proceed?
Yes.
Pretty women, fascinating, sipping coffee, dancing. Pretty women are a wonder. Pretty women. Sitting in the window or standing on the stairs, something in them cheers the air. Pretty women,
silhouetted,
stay within you,
glancing.
Pretty women,
breathing lightly.
Pretty women,
pretty women,
blowing out their candles or combing out their hair,
even when they leave you and vanish, they somehow
still women at the mirrors,
in their gardens,
letter writing,
flower picking,
weather watching,
how they make a man sing. Proof of heaven as you're living.
Pretty women,
pretty women,
yes,
pretty women, pretty women.
Joanna marries me Sunday, everything set. We,
you,
Judge Turpin.
There is indeed a higher power to warn me thus in time. Joanna, elope with you!
But, sir, I beg you.
Lock her up in some obscure retreat, where neither you nor any other vile, corrupting youth shall ever lay eyes on her again. And as for you, barber, it is all too clear what company you keep. Service them well and keep their custom, for you will have none of mine.
Get out.
Mr. Todd.
Out, I say!
and shouting. What is it now, dear?
I had him. And then...
The sailor busted in. I saw them both running down the street and I thought to myself, the bat's in the fire for sure.
I had him. Hester was there beneath my hands.
Now, dear, don't fret.
I had him, so he's there, and he'll never come again.
Easy now, hush, love, hush. I'll keep telling you.
When?
What's your rush?
Why did I wait? You told me to wait. Now he'll never come again. There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and its paws aren't worth what a pig could spit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it. But not for long. They all deserve to die. Tell you why, Mrs. Lovett, tell you why. Because in all the whole human race, Mrs. Lovett, there are two kinds of men and only two. So one staying put in its proper place, and the one with its foot in the other one's face. Look at me, Mrs. Lovett, look at you. No, we all deserve to die. Even you, Mrs. Lovett, even I. The lives of the wicked should be made brief. For the rest of us, death will be our relief. We all deserve to die and never see Joanna. No, I'll never hold my girl to me. Finished. All right, you, sir, how about a shave? Come and visit your good friend Sweeney. You, sir, too, sir, welcome to the grave. I will have vengeance. I will have salvation. You, sir, too, sir, no one's in the chair. Come on! Sweeney's waiting. I want you bleeders. You, sir, anybody. Gentlemen, now don't be shy. Not one man, no, nor 10 men, nor 100 can assuage me. I will have you. And I will get him back. Even as he gloats, in the meantime I'll practice on less honorable throats, and my Lucy lies in ashes, and I'll never see my girl again. But the work waits. I'm alive at last, and I'm full of joy.
All very well, but all that matters now is in. Listen, do you hear me? Can you hear me? Get control of yourself. What are we going to do with him? And there's the lad downstairs. We'd better go and have a look and be sure he's still there. Come on. When I left him, he was sound asleep in the parlour. No problem there. He's still sleeping. He's simple as a baby lamb. Later on, I can fob him off easy with some story, but him, what are we going to do with him?
Later on, when it's dark, we'll take it to some secret place and bury it.
Well, of course, we could do that. I don't suppose he's got any relatives who are going to come poking around looking for him. Well, you know me, bright ideas just pop into me head and I keep thinking. Seems a downright shame.
Shame?
It seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame, what his name has. Nor it can't be traced. Business needs a lift. Debts to be erased. Think of it as thrift, as a gift, if you get my drift. No.
seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it.
Oh.
Good you've got it. Take for instance Mrs. Mooney and her pie shop. Business never better using only pussycats and toast. Now a pussy's good for maybe 6 or 7 at the most. And I'm sure they can't compare as far as taste.
Mrs. Lovett, your charming notion,
well, eminently it does seem
and yet appropriate
words.
As always. Mrs. Lovett, how
what,
I live without
dear?
You all these years, I never know. How delectable!
So undetectable!
So undetectable! Our choice, our air, for what's the sound of the world out there?
What, Mr. Todd, what, Mr. Todd, what is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading the air.
Yes, Mr. Todd, yes, Mr. Todd, yes, all around.
It's man devouring man, my dear.
And who are we to deny it in here?
Oh, these are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett. And desperate measures are called for.
Here we are now, hot from the oven.
What is that?
It's priest. I've a little priest.
Is it any good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, they don't commit sins of the flesh. So it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only where it's sat.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
Now you see, the trouble with poet is, how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
Heavenly. Not as hardy as bishop, but not as bland as cleric either.
And good for business too. Always leaves you wanting more. Trouble is, we only get it on Sundays. Lawyer's rather nice.
If it's for a price.
Order something else, though, to follow, since no one should swallow it twice.
Anything that's lean?
Well, then, if you're British and loyal, you might enjoy Royal Marine. Anyway, it's clean, though, of course, it tastes of wherever it's been.
Is that squire on the fire?
See now, sir, look closer, you'll notice it's grosser.
Looks thicker, more like thicker.
No. Grosser, it's green.
The history of the world, my love.
Save a lot of graves, do a lot of relatives favors.
Is those below serving those up above?
Everybody shaves, so there should be plenty of flavors.
How gratifying for once to know
that those above will serve those down below.
We've got, Tinker?
Something pinker.
Taylor.
Something paler.
Butler.
Something subtler.
Porter.
Something hotter.
Locksmith.
Something...
Lovely bit of clerk.
Maybe for a lark.
Then again, they're sweet if you want it cheap and you like it dark. Try the financier, think of his career.
That looks pretty right.
Well, he drank, now it's bank cashier. Never really sold, maybe it was old.
Have you any beetle?
Next week, so I'm told. Beetle isn't bad till you smell it and notice how well it's been graced. Stick to priest. This may be a bit stringy, but then, of course, it's, fiddle player.
No, no, this isn't fiddle player. It's piccolo player.
How can you tell?
It's piping hot.
Then blow on it first.
The history of the world, my sweet.
Save a lot of graves, do a lot of relatives' favors.
Is who gets eaten and who gets to eat.
And Mr. Todd too, Mr. Todd, who gets to sell.
But fortunately, it's all so clear
that everybody goes down where with beer.
Since Marine doesn't appear.
appeal to you. How about Rear Admiral?
Too salty. I prefer General.
With or without his privates? With is extra.
What is that?
It's fop. Finest in the shop. And I've got some shepherd's pie peppered with actual shepherd on top. And I've just begun. Here's a politician so oily it's served with a doily, not one.
Put it on a bun. Well, you never know if it's going to run.
Train and fryer, fried and dryer.
No, the clergy is really too coarse and too mealy.
An actor, that's compactor.
Yes, it always arrives overdone. I'll come again when you have judge on the menu.
Wait, true, we don't have judge yet. But would you settle for the next best thing?
What's that?
Executioner.
Have charity towards the world, my pet.
Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
High born and low, my love.
We'll not discriminate great from small. No, we'll serve anyone, meaning anyone, and to anyone.
Gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Are your nostrils a quivering, tingling as well at that delicate, luscious, ambrosial smell? Yes, they are, I can tell. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that aroma enriching the breeze is like nothing compared to its succulent sauce the gourmets among you will tell you, of course. Ladies and gentlemen, you can't imagine the rapture in store. Just inside of this door. There you'll sample Mrs. Lovett's meat pies, savory and sweet pies, as you'll see. You who eat pies, Mrs. Lovett's meat pies, conjure up the treat pies used to be.
Over here, boy, how about something?
Let me have another
right away.
Can we have some service, waiter?
But ladies and gentlemen,
Toby?
Coming, excuse me.
Ale there.
Right, Mom.
Quick now.
God, that's good.
Nice to see you, dearie. How have you been keeping? Call me Bones is weary. Toby, one for the gentleman here. The bird is cheeping. Hopes to keep it cheery. Toby, throw the old woman out.
God, that's good.
What's your pleasure, dearie? No, we don't cut slices. Call me eyes as blurry. Toby, none for the gentleman. I could up me prices. I'm a little leery. Business couldn't be better than
God, that's good.
Knock on wood. Psst. Excuse me. Psst. Dear, see to the customers. Psst. Yes, what, love? Quick, though the trade is brisk.
But it's 6 o'clock.
So it's 6 o'clock.
It was due to arrive at a quarter to five
and
it's 6 o'clock.
And it's probably already down the block. It'll be. It'll
I've been
be.
Waiting all day.
Well,
it should have been here by now.
Will you wait?
You'll come
there.
Back when it comes.
Because my customers truly are getting unruly. And what's a pleasure, dearie? Oops, I beg your pardon. Just me hands is smeary. Toby, run for the gentleman. Don't you love a garden? Always makes me teary. Must be one of them foreigners.
God, that's good. That is delicious.
What's my secret? Frankly, dear, forgive my kind of family secret. All to do with herbs. Things like being careful with your coriander. That's what makes the gravy grander.
More hot pies! More hot! More pies!
Psst, excuse me. Psst, dear, see to the customer. miss. Psst, yes, what, love, quick, though the trade is brisk.
But it's here.
It's where?
Coming up the stairs.
I'm going in this lot, it's still pretty hot, and then
it's about to be open. No, don't you care.
I will leave.
But we have to prepare.
Love would be sore if I let him get cold enough. Incidentally, dairy, you know Mrs. Mooney, sales have been so dreary. Toby, poor thing's penniless, what about that loony? Looking sort of beery. Oh, well, gotta come up, and that I'll be dropping some.
God, that's good sound, she's sweet. Have you licious ever tasted smell such? Oh my God, what more? That spice good.
That a chaffet for a king of wondrous need and most particular chair. You tell me where is the receipt can half
it's
compete
perfect.
With this particular thing. I have a few minor adjustments
few minor
to
adjustments.
Make. They'll take.
You take your time,
moment.
I'll go see
I'll
to the customers.
I have another friend.
That a pipe fit for a king are wondrous
it's gorgeous.
And most
it's
particular
gorgeous.
You tell me where there is a meat pie can come
it's perfect.
Eat with this
it's
delectable
gorgeous.
Pie. The crust of velvety
the
and wavy, that
glaze,
those crisps,
that glaze,
and then
those
the succulent taste,
and then the succulent
of
wavy,
the
excuse me, dear, see to the customers. All set, love.
Quick, now.
We hearts are flutter.
When I pound the floor.
When you pound the floor.
It's a signal to show them
you
I'm ready
me,
to go.
You told me I know you'll be ready to go.
Floor.
When you pound the floor, will you trust me? Will
I
you
just
trust
want to be
me?
Sure.
I'll be waiting below when
no,
a whistle
sir,
to blow.
The door in place. I'll pound three times. Three times. And then you. Three times. If you... Exactly.
More hot pies.
God.
More hot.
Right.
More pies. More.
White. Be here in a twinkling, just confirms my theory. Toby, garbage is arrested and have an inkling. Positively airy, Toby, throw the old woman out.
That's good, that is deep. Have you delicious ever tasted, smelled such? Oh my God, what perfect boy, that's my such flavor. God, that's good.
I feel you, Joanna. I feel you. Do they think that walls can hide you? Even now I'm at your window. I am in the dark beside you. Buried sweetly in your yellow hair, Joe.
And are you beautiful and pale with yellow hair like her? I'd want you beautiful and pale the way I dreamed you were, Joanna. And if you're beautiful, what then, with yellow hair like wheat? I think we shall not meet again, my little dove, my sweet Joanna. Goodbye, Joanna. You're gone and yet you're mine. I'm fine, Joanna. I'm fine.
Smoke, smoke, sign of the devil, sign of the devil, city on fire. Witch, witch, smell and miss an evil smell. Every night at the Vespers bell, smoke that comes from the mouth of hell. City on fire, city on fire. Mischief, mischief, mischief.
And if I never hear your voice, my turtle dove, my dear, I still have a reason to rejoice. The way ahead is clear, Joanna.
Ebony Sunday, Ebony Sunday.
And in the darkness when I'm blind, with what I can't forget, it's always morning in my mind, my little lamb, my pet, Joanna.
I knew you'd come for me one day, come for me one day.
You stay, Joanna, the way I dreamed you are. Oh, look, Joanna, a star.
Buried sweetly in your yellow hair.
A shooting star.
Somebody look up there. Didn't I tell you smell that air? City on fire. Quick, miss, run and tell. Warn them all of the witch's spell. There it is, the unholy spell. Now it's the beat of the police as well. Tell him, tell him, help, back. City on fire. City on fire. Mischief, mischief, mischief. Fiend.
I'll think of you, I guess, until the day I die. I think I miss you less and less as every day goes by, Joanna. Joanna.
Oh, if you'll be, sign me on Sunday, married on Sunday.
Beautiful and pale, not too much like her. If only angels could prevail, we'd be the way we were, Joanna.
Joanna.
You stay, Joanna, the way I dreamed you are. Oh, look, Joanna, a star. Goodbye.
Joanna?
Joanna! 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 Oh, sir, please tell me, what house is this?
That there is Mr. Frog's private asylum for the mentally deranged.
A madhouse?
I'd keep away from there if I were you.
Joanna! Joanna! Oh, somebody open the door! Somebody open the door! Joanna, come
now, friend, what's all this hollering and shouting?
Oh, sir, there's been a monstrous perversion of justice. A young woman as sane as you as I has been incarcerated there.
Is that a fact? And what is this young person's name?
Joanna.
Joanna. That wouldn't be Judge Turpin's ward, would it?
He's the one. He's the devil incarnate who's done this to her.
You watch your tongue. That girl's as mad as the seven seas. I brought her here myself. So hop it.
You've no right to order me about.
No right, eh? You just hop it, or I'm booking you for disturbing of the peace, assailing an officer.
Is there no justice in the city? Are the officers of the law as vicious and corrupt as their masters? Joanna, Joanna, oh somebody, Joanna, open the door, open the door.
After him, get him, bash him in the head. Gets this neighborhood into disrepute.
Lad, who alas has alas in Canterbury, tis a row, dow, diddle, dow, day, tis a row, dow, diddle, dow, dee, tis a row, dow, diddle, dow, day, tis a row, dow, diddle, dow, dee. I am alas, who alas has alas, who alas has alas in Canterbury, tis a row. Dow, diddle, dow, day, tis a row, dow, diddle, dow, dee. Nothing like a nice sit down, is there, dear, after a hard day's work? Now, let me see. 4 and 3 pence, 4 and 11 pence. That makes 7 pounds, 9 shillings, and 4 pence for this week. Not bad, and that don't include what I had to pay out for my lovely harmonium. And a real bargain it was, dear, it being only partly singed when the chapel burnt down. Mr. T, are you listening to me?
Yes.
Then what did I say, eh?
There must be a way to the judge.
The bloody old judge. Always hopping on the bloody old judge. We got a nice, respectable business now. Money coming in regular, and since we're careful to pick and choose, strangers and what like won't be missed, who's going to catch on? Oh, Mr. Todd, I'm so happy I could eat you up, I really could. You know what I'd like to do, Mr. Todd, what I dream, if the business stays as good, where I'd really like to go in a year or so. Don't you want to know?
Yes, sir.
Do you really want to know?
Yes, yes, of course.
I've always had a dream. Ever since I was a skinny little slip of a thing, and my rich aunt Nettie used to take me down to the seaside, August bank holiday, the pier, making little castles in the sand, I can still feel me toes wiggling round in the briny. By the sea, Mr. Todd, that's the life I covet. By the sea, Mr. Todd, ooh, I know you'd love it. You and me, Mr. T, we could be alone in a house what we'd almost own. Down by the sea, wouldn't that be smashing? With the sea at our gate, we'll have kippered airing. What a swamp to a straight from the Straits of Bering. Every night in the kip, when we're through our kippers, I'll be there slipping off your slippers by the sea. With the fishy splashing by the sea, wouldn't that be smart?
ocean, down by the sea.
Anything you say, anything you say.
I can see us waking, the breakers breaking, the seagulls squawking. Ooh, ooh, I do me faking that I go walking with you, you. I warm me bones on the esplanade, have tea and scones with me gay young blade. Then I'll knit a sweater while you write a letter, unless we got better to do.
Anything you say.
Think how snug it'll be underneath our flannel when it's just you and me and the English Channel in our cozy retreat, kept on the and tidy. We'll have shams over every Friday by the sea.
Anything you say.
Don't you love the weather by the sea? We'll grow old together to the sea. Say boo-hoo by the beautiful sea. Oh, I can see us now in our bathing dresses. You in a nice rich navy, and me, stripes perhaps. It'll be so quiet that who'll come by it except a seagull. Ooh, ooh, we shouldn't try it though till it's legal for two. But a seaside wedding could be devised. Me rumpled bedding legitimise. Me eyelids will flutter, I'll turn into butter the moment I mutter, I do. By the sea in a nest, we can share our kippers with the odd paying guests from the weekend trippers. Have a nice sunny suite for the guests to rest in. Now and then you can do the guesting by the sea. Marry nice and proper by the sea. Bring along your chopper to the seaside. Ooh, ooh, by the beautiful sea. Come on, dear. Give us a kiss. Well, that was lovely. Now, you do love me just a little bit, don't you?
Yes.
Then how about it? Of course, there'd have to be a little trip down to St. Swithers to legalise things, but that wouldn't be too painful now, would it?
I'll make them pay for what they did to Lucy.
Now, dear, it's high time you forgot all about them morbid fancies. Your Lucy's gone, poor thing. It's your Nelly now. Here, have a nice bonbon. You know, it's been 17 years this Whitsun since me poor Albert's passed on. I don't see why I shouldn't be married in white, do you?
Mr. Todd, I found her.
You have found Joanna?
That monster of a judge had her locked away in a madhouse.
Where? Where?
At Mr. Fogg's private asylum. Oh, Mr. Todd, she's in there with those screeching, gibbering maniacs.
A madhouse. A madhouse. Joanna's as good as saved.
She is?
Where do you suppose all the wig makers in London obtain their human hair?
I don't know. The morgue? Wouldn't be surprised.
Bedlam. They get it from the lunatics at Bedlam.
Then you think?
Fogg's asylum? Why not? For the right amount, they'll give you the hair off of any madman's head.
And the scalp to go with it, if requested. Excuse me, gentlemen, I'm out.
We will write a letter to this Mr. Fogg, offering the highest amount for hair, the exact shade of Joanna's, which I assume you know.
Yellow?
Not good enough. We'll have to make you into a credible wig maker, and quickly.
There's tawny, and there's golden saffron, there's flaxen, and there's blonde. Repeat that.
There's tawny, and there's golden saffron, there's flaxen, and there's blonde.
Sweeney waited too long before, but never again he swore.
Fortune arrived, Sweeney it sang, Sweeney was ready and Sweeney sprang.
Sweeney's problems went up in smoke, all results with a single stroke.
Sweeney was sharp. Sweeney was burning, Sweeney began, the end is turning.
Sweeney was sharp, Sweeney was burning, Sweeney began, the end is turning. Sweeney, 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 Sweeney.
and a pistol. For if kill you must, kill.
I'll kill a dozen jailers if need be to set her free.
Then off with you. But Anthony, listen to me once more. When you have rescued Joanna, bring her here. I shall guard her while you hire a chassis to Plymouth.
We'll be with you before the evening's out. Mr. Todd,
thank you again,
friend.
Honorable Judge Turpin.
Most honorable.
I venture thus to write you this
urgent
note to warn you that the hot-blooded
young sailor
persuaded the boy to lodge her here tonight at my tonsorial parlor in Fleet Street. If you want her again in your arms, hurry after the night falls.
She will be waiting,
Your obedient humble servant.
Hand this to Judge Turpin. It's urgent.
Lovely muffler, and guess who it's for?
Cool, Mom. For me?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Oh, Mom, you're so good to me. Sometimes, when I think of what it was like with Signor Pirelli, it seems the good Lord sent me for you.
It's just me warm heart, dear. Room enough there for all God's creatures.
You know, there's nothing I wouldn't do for you if there was a monster or an ogre or anything bad like that. What might be after you? I'd tear him apart with my bare fists. I would.
What a sweet child it is.
Or even if it was just a man.
A man, dear?
A man. What was bad? What might be luring you, all unbeknownst, into his evil deeds?
What is this? What are you talking about?
Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around.
Of course not, Dean. Why should it?
Nothing's gonna harm you, no sir, not while I'm around.
What do you mean, a man?
Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays.
And so they are, dear.
I'll send them howling, I don't care, I got ways.
Of course you do. What a sweet, affectionate child it is.
No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare.
I know what Toby deserves.
Others can desert you, not to worry, Whistle, I'll be there.
Here, have a nice bonbon.
Demons will charm you with a smile for a while,
But in time, nothing can harm you. Not while I'm around.
What are you talking about? What is this foolishness?
It's him, you see. Mr. Todd. Oh, I know you fancy him, but men ain't like women. They ain't what you can trust, as I've lived and learned. Worry, not to worry. I may not be smart, but I ain't dumb. I can do it, put me to it, show me something I can overcome. Not to worry, Mom. Being close and being clever ain't like being true. I don't need to, I won't ever hide a thing from you. Like some.
Now, Toby dear, let's stop all this foolish chatter and just sit nice and quiet. Here.
Dad, that's in your brother's purse.
What was that, dear?
That proves it. Well, I've been thinking that's his purse.
No, silly boy. It's just a silly little something Mr. T gave me for my birthday.
Mr. Todd gave it to you. And where did he get it? Where did he get it?
Bought it, dear. In a pawn shop, dear. Come on. Nothing's gonna harm you. Not while I'm around. Nothing's gonna harm you, darling. Not when I'm around.
You don't understand. It was in the parlour when the governor disappeared.
Boys and their fancies. What will we think of next? Now, why don't you sit here by your Aunt Nellie like a good boy and look at your lovely muffler? How warm it'll keep you when the day's drawing, and it's so becoming on you.
Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing can harm you. Not while I'm around.
Toby, dear, you know, it's the strangest thing you come to chat with me right now of all moments, because as I was sitting here with my needles, I was thinking, what a good boy Toby is. So hardworking, so obedient. And you know who I've always fancied coming to help me with the pies?
Oh, yes, Mum.
Well, how about it?
Really? You mean it? I can help make them and bake them.
No time like the present now, is there?
Oh, Coop, quite a stink, ain't there?
Them steps lead down to the old cellars and the whiffs come up, love. God knows what's down there, so dark and mouldy. And there's always a couple of rats gone home to Jesus. Now, here's the bake ovens.
They're big enough, ain't they?
Hardly big enough to bake all the pies we sell. 10 dozen at a time. Now, always be sure to close the doors properly, like this. Now, here's the grinder. You put the meat in here, you grind it, and it comes out here. And you want to know the secret that makes our pie so sweet and juicy? 3 times. You must put the meat through the grinder 3 times.
3 times, say.
That's my boy. Smoothly, smoothly. As soon as a new batch of meat comes in, we'll put you to work.
Me making my pies all on me own. Cue! Where are you going, Mom?
Be back in a moment, love.
Smoothly. Smoothly.
Mrs. Lovett? Mrs. Lovett?
Mr. Todd, Mr. Todd!
sweet Polly Plunkett lay in the grass, turned her eyes heavenward, sighing. I am a lass who, alas, loves a lad who, alas, has a lass in Canterbury. Tis a row-dow, diddle-dow-day. Tis a row-dow, diddle-dow-day.
Oh, Beadle Banford, I didn't know you were a music lover too.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Lovett. Fine instrument you've acquired.
Ah, yes. She's my pride and joy.
Well, ma'am, I hope you have a few moments, for I'm here today on official business.
Official?
That's right. You see, there's been complaints.
Complaints?
About the stink from your chimney. They say at night it's something foul. Health regulations being my duty, I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to let me take a look.
At the bakehouse?
That's right, ma'am.
But it's locked and I don't have the key. Mr. Todd, upstairs, he's got the key and he's not here right now.
When will he be back?
Couldn't say, I'm sure.
Oh, one of Mother's favourites. If one bell rings in the Tower of Bray, ding dong, your true love will stay. Ding dong,
one bell today in the Tower of Bray, ding dong.
What's that?
Oh, it's just me boy, what helps me with the pies.
But surely he's in the bakehouse, isn't he?
Oh, yes, but you see, he's simple in the head. Last week he ran off, and we didn't find him till 2 days later, down by the embankment, half-starved. Poor thing. So, ever since then, we locked him in for his own security.
Well, then we'll just have to wait for Mr. Todd, won't we?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. Mr. Todd's gone down to Wapping. Won't be back for hours, and he'll be ever so sorry to miss you. Why? Just the other day he was saying, if only the Beadle would grace my tonsorial parlour, I would give him the most stylish haircut and the daintiest of shaves, all for nothing. So, why don't you just stop on by some other time and take him up on his offer?
Well, that's real friendly of him.
Back already! Look who's here on some foolish complaint about the bakehouse or something. He wants the key and I told him you had it, but there's no rush now, is there, sir? Why don't you go upstairs with Mr. Todd and let him fix you up nice and pretty? There'll be plenty of time for the bakehouse later.
Well, tell me, Mr. Todd, do you pomade the hair? I dearly love a pomaded head.
Pomade, of course, and a nice facial rub with bay rum too, all for free.
Well, I take that very kindly, sir.
I am, sir, entirely at your disposal.
Let's hope he can do it quietly, but just to be on the safe side, we'll give him a little musical send-off. Sweet Polly Plunkett lay in the grass, turned her eyes heavenward, sighing.
An air black as a rook. Now that ain't Mrs. Lovett's air. Oh well, some old black cow probably. Coo, a bit of fingernail. I'm here. No. Oh, no. No. Mrs. Lovett! Mrs. Lovett! Let me out! Let me out! Mrs. Lovett!
She's a row-dow-diddle-dow-dee.
It is done.
Not yet, it isn't. The boy, he's guessed.
Guess what?
About Pirelli. You weren't here, so I locked him in the bakehouse. He's been yelling to wake the dead. We've got to look after him.
But the judge is coming. I've arranged it.
You, worrying about the bloody judge at a time like this. Come on.
engine roared, the motor hissed.
In Sweeney's ledger, the entry snatched. A beetle arrived and a beetle dispatched
to satisfy the hungry god
of Sweeney Todd.
The demon barber of
Sweeney
Street.
Sweeney,
Sweeney, Sweeney, Sweeney, Sweeney.
Just this way, sir.
Do me honour, Mr. Falk.
Now, I agree it would be to our mutual interest to come to some arrangement in regard to me poor children's hair.
Your children?
Why, we are one happy family here, sir, and all my patients are my children. To be corrected when they're naughty, and rewarded with a sweetie when they're good. But to our business. Here, a charming yellow, a little dull in tone perhaps, but you can soon restore its natural gleam.
No.
Now here, a fine texture for a man, and as you must know, sir, there is always a discount on the hair of a male.
This one here is hair the shade I seek.
Poor child, she needs so much correction. She sings all day and night and leaves the other inmates sleepless. Come, child, smile for the gentleman. He shall have a sweet. Now, where shall I cut?
Anthony!
Joanna!
What is this? What is
this? Unhand her!
Why, you are...
Step back, Mr. Fogg, or I'll fire.
Fire? And I will stop.
I cannot shoot.
City on fire, rats in the grass, and the lunatics
yelling in the streets.
Is the end of the world? Yes, city on fire, hunchbacks dancing, stirring in the ground, and the whirring of giant winds. Look,
running
and
pulling like a big black crane.
City on fire, city on fire,
city on fire.
Will we be married on Sunday? That's what you promised, married on Sunday. That was last August. Kiss me!
There was Brian Chimney Stick!
Black prostitution! City on fire! City on fire! City on fire!
Toby, where are you, lad?
Toby, where are you, lad?
Nothing's gonna harm you!
Toby!
Not while I'm around!
Toby!
Where are you hiding? Nothing's gonna harm you! Darling.
Nothing to be afraid of, boy.
Not while I'm around.
Toby!
Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays.
Toby!
City on fire, rats in the streets, and the lunatics yelling in the moon. It's the end of the world!
Yes! Beetle! Beetle! No good. Watch it. She's a wicked one. She'll deceive you with her fancy gowns and her fancy airs and her mischief. Mischief! Devil's work! Where are you, Beetle? Beetle!
Rats in the streets and the lunatics yelling in the moon is the end of the world. Yes, city on fire! Rats in the streets and city on fire! Hard rats, giants, wings went out! Look! City on fire!
Mr. Todd?
No one here. Where is Mr. Todd?
No matter. He'll be back in a moment. For I trust him as I trust my right arm. Wait here. I'll return with the coach in less than an hour.
But they're still after us. What if they trace us here? Oh, Anthony, please let me come with you.
No, my darling. There's no safety for you on the street.
But dressed in these sailor clothes, who's to know it is I?
No. The risk is too great. Miss, look at me, look at me, miss, oh, look at me, please, oh, favor me with your glance. Ah, miss, soon we'll be gone and sailing the seas and happily, happily wed in France. And we'll sail the world and see its wonders, from the pearls of Spain to the rubies of Tibet. And then come back to London someday. And I'll be back before that face has time to lose its smile.
I say!
Hey, don't I know you, mister?
Judge, oh, I have no time.
Where is she? Where's the girl?
Below, Your Honor, with my neighbor, Mrs. Lovett. Thank heavens the sailor did not molest her. Thank heavens, too, she has seen the error of her ways.
She has.
Oh, yes, sir, she speaks only of you, longing for forgiveness.
And she shall have it. She'll be here soon, you say.
I think I hear her now.
Oh, excellent, my friend.
Shh, is that a dainty footstep on the stairs?
I hear nothing.
Is that a shadow on the wall?
Where?
There! Primping, making herself even prettier than
even
usual,
prettier.
If possible.
Oh, pretty women.
Pretty women.
Quick, sir, splash of me rum.
Sit, sir, sit!
Joanna, Joanna.
Pretty women.
Pretty man.
Pretty women are a wonder.
You're in a merry mood again today, barber. Women. What we do for pretty women.
Blowing out their,
candles,
or combing out their,
hair. Then they leave,
even when they,
leave you and vanish, they
still,
are
there.
How seldom it is one meets a fellow spirit.
With fellow tastes in women, at least.
What was that?
Oh, no doubt the years have changed me, sir. But then again, the face of a barber, the face of a prisoner on the docks, not particularly memorable.
Benjamin Barker?
Benjamin Barker!
Now forever, sleep now the untroubled sleep of the angels.
Tobias! My razors. You, what are you doing here? Speak.
Oh, dear. Excuse me, sir. I saw the barber sign, so thinking of asking for a shave, I...
A shave, eh? At your service.
But, sir, anything that I have seen, no one shall ever know.
Whatever you may have seen, your cheeks are still as much in need of the razor. Sit, sir, sit!
But, sir...
Torment me. Quick, into the oven with her.
Judge lives still.
He was clutching, holding onto my skirt, but now he's finished.
Leave them to me. Open the oven doors.
No.
Open the doors, I said.
No, don't go near her.
What's the matter with you, woman? She's only some half-crazed beggar. Oh, my God! Oh, no. Don't I know you, she said. You knew she lived. From the moment I walked into your shop, you knew my Lucy lived.
I was only thinking of you.
Lucy.
You're Lucy, a crazy hag, picking bones and rotten spuds out of the ash cans. Would you want to know that that was all that was left of her?
You lied to me.
No, no, not lied at all. No one ever lied that you took the poison. She did never said that she died. Poor thing, she lived, but it left a week in the head. All she did for months was just lie there in bed. Should have been in hospital, wound up in bed. Poor thing, better you should think she was dead. Yes, I lied, cause I'm
you're a bloody wonder, eminently practical and yet appropriate as always. As you said repeatedly, there's little point in dwelling on the past. So come here, my love. Not a thing to fear, my love. What's dead is dead. The history of the world, my pet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, leave it to me.
Is learn forgiveness and try to forget.
But the sea, Mr. Todd, would be comfy, cozy. You and me, Mr. Todd, but there's no one knows it.
And life is for the alive, my dear. So let's keep living it. Just keep living it. Really living it. And his life, and she was beautiful, and she was virtuous, and he was naive.
Had a cake maker man. No. Bake me a pie to delight my eye, and I will sigh if the crust be high. Mr. Todd, you harmed her too, haven't you? You know you shouldn't.
shouldn't harm nobody.
Get out!
Razor, razor. Cut, 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 Cadone. Atom and prick 'em. Mark 'em with B. Put 'em in the oven for baby and me. You'll pardon me, gentlemen, but you may not enter here. Oh, no. Me, miss, don't let anyone enter here. For you see, sirs, there's much work to be done. So much work. Three times. That's the secret. Three times through the grinder. For them to be tender and juicy. Three times through. Smoothly. Smoothly. Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd. His skin was pale, his eye was odd.
He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again.
He trod a path that few have trod, to Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
He kept a shop in London town, of fancy coins and good renown.
And what if none of their souls were saved? They went with a maker to peck up the shame.
By Sweeney, by Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
Swing your razor wide, Sweeney, hold it to the skies. Freely flows the blood of
his room is bare. He hardly used his fancy share. The more he bleeds, the more he lives. He never forgets and he never forgives. Perhaps today you gave a nod to Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. Sweeney wishes the world away. Sweeney's weeping for yesterday, hugging the blade, waiting the years, hearing the music that nobody hears. Sweeney lives in the water hall. Sweeney lives in the office wall. Nothing can help, nothing can hide you. Isn't that Sweeney there beside you? Nothing can help, nothing can hide you. Isn't that Sweeney there beside you? Sweeney wishes the world away. Sweeney's weeping yesterday.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
He served a dark and a hungry god.
He served a dark and a hungry god.
To seek revenge may lead to hell,
but everyone does it if seldom as well.
A Sweeney. A Sweeney Todd. The demon barber of Fleet Street.
I feel ashamed of everything I'm doing right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Guilford High School and the cast of Sweeney Todd. Yeah!
Sweeney Todd. Sweeney blink and rats with the toe. Sweeney was Sweeney, but Sweeney was so. Sweeney was black and rats with the toe. Sweeney was Sweeney, but Sweeney was Sweeney.
These are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett, and desperate measures are called for.
Here we are now, hot from the oven.
What is that?
It's hot. Honest in the shop. And I've got some shepherd's pie peppered with actual shepherd on top. And I've just begun. He's a politician, so oily, it's served with a doily, that one.
No, if it's going to run.
Run, Ryder, Ryder, Ryder.
No, the clergy is really too close.
Beer. Then after, that's the founder.
Yes, we'll always arrive overdone. How come again when you have judge on the menu?
Wait, true, we don't have judge yet. But would you settle the next best thing?
How dare she towards the world, my pet?
Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
High, more than low, my love.
We won't discriminate great from small. No better serve anyone,
meaning
anyone, and to anyone.
And of course, our amazing production director, Mrs. Mulqueen Teasdale, for all of their leadership, dedication, and everlasting love and support. Thank you very much, and we all love you.
Featured performer are
Tyler Phelps.
Is it like-
It has been such an honor to work with the cast and crew of Sweeney Todd. I really couldn't have asked for a better family to get to know these past few months. I also want to give a huge thanks to Mr. Ripa, Mr. Gum, and all of Guilford High School Theater Arts for making my high school experience exponentially better. Thanks to my parents and my grandfather who is here in the audience, so thanks for coming, I love you. And of course, I would be so remiss if not for my amazing musical director, Mr. Bruno, and musical director, Ms. Malkin Teasdale, for helping me and inspiring me beyond words. So thank you so much for this award. What a way to end senior year, so thank you.
For the 2017 Award for Outstanding Achievement in Hair and Makeup Design are
Andrea Kennedy, Amity Regional High School. Dana Shelton. Jenny DeBlois, North Kingston High School, Oklahoma. Victoria Strito, Notre Dame High School, Sioux Falls. Gina Gallo, Mandy Rosario, Ella Williamson, and Angela Cetragella, Trumbull High School, Sioux Falls.
And the winner is Dana Shelton.
For Outstanding Achievement in Lighting Design are
Dan Hassemeyer, Fiddler of the Michael Hyde, North Kingston High School, Oklahoma. Rich Parsons, St. Paul Catholic High School. Christopher Tyson.
Thank you.
my amazing crew who put so much time and effort into the lighting for Sweeney Todd, but our director, Ms. Mulqueen Teasdale, our technical director, Nick Ripa, and our lighting advisor, Mr. Edmund Spence. Everyone worked so hard on this, and it's really just amazing to be here. And she's not up here with me, but my other crew chief, Jess Warner.
I love you!
Amazing person to work with, and it's just been such an amazing experience to finish 4 years doing Sweeney Todd. Thank you.
I just want to say thank you so much for even the nomination of this award. It means so much to me. Being a part of the Sweeney Todd production crew was truly an honor. I've never worked with such talented people, the technicians, the cast, everybody was just fantastic, and I'm so glad to have been a part of it. Thank you.
Producing is not an easy job, even when everything goes well. And it takes a lot of support from your peers and from your mentors to accomplish what you're trying to. So I would like to thank Ms. Karen Mulqueen Teasdale for all the help and support that she's given me. My best friend, Alec Covey, who has been alongside me in theater these past 4 years. And all the cast of Sweeney Todd, who have been wonderful in making this production come alive. So thank you.
Nothing that we have done could be possible without the help of the entire cast, crew, and pit, and all of our amazing technical directors, our musical directors, and of course, Miss Mulqueen. And I've never worked with a team that that made me so happy. I've never had an experience like this before, and I'm so thankful for the Connecticut High School Music Theater Awards for giving us this opportunity.
I'm not really one for the stage, so I'll keep this brief, but I'm really proud to say I played a small part in all of what happened with Sweeney Todd, and thank you to the Theater Awards Association for this award and this glorious chaos of the day. Thank you to everybody in the cast and the crew and the pit who put in so many hours to working on the show. I think blew away the last 2 years and it gave us a new experience in theater. Thank you to Ms. Mulqueen for greenlighting when I get carried away with everything, and Mr. Ripa for all of his guidance, and you know, when I take photo stuff, he's okay with it. And thank you to everybody else who made Sweeney possible.
Be considered for a nomination in this category, the orchestras for a school musical must be comprised of at least 75% student musicians. This year's nominees for outstanding performance by a student orchestra are
Amity Regional High School.
Thank some of the most wonderful people here tonight and in the world. The wonderful adult production team of Sweeney Todd, many of whom who are here tonight, and in particular, a few, starting with Nick Ripa. Nick, you are a problem solver, a team player, and a real artist. Mr. Kevin Buno, Kevin, back there somewhere. Kevin, I admire so much the way you nurture the students' musicianship as well as their humanity. Kara Mulqueen, who I am so impressed that you treat every moment like a teachable moment, including earlier today as the students were rehearsing for this, and she was telling them that the only recognition that mattered was that the students handled themselves beautifully today, and of course they have and always will. What a wonderful team to work with. And of course, my students in the pit, after all, they're the ones that make all the noise. That put the whole thing together. Thank you.
Good evening. Musical direction encompasses many areas, including balance between singers, musicians and amplification, the accuracy of rhythm, notes and pitches, harmony, diction, dynamics, lyrics, musical interpretation, including phrasing, transitions, and ultimately, style. This year's nominees for Outstanding Achievement in Musical Direction are...
Marsha Rizzotti.
Miss Kara Mulqueen Teasdale. I'm so grateful for what we do together to bring such joy to all of our students' lives. And we're seeing it this evening, but we see it well beyond as they continue in their next chapters. So thank you so very, very much. As my kids make fun of me for saying this, I would be remiss. Especially our theater arts parental support group, who does so incredibly much to make our productions what we are on stage. Thank you so much. And all that they've done to make that what it is. And finally, our Guilford High School and Public Schools Administration, Rick Macenti, our principal, Julia Chaff, our assistant principal, Paul Freeman, our superintendent, and our former assistant principal, who was a phenomenal, phenomenal advocate for us as well, and now at Trumbull High School, Mr. Mark Marino. We're so grateful for you. Thank you.
The nominees for Outstanding Achievement by a Teacher or Outside Director are...
Robert and Andrea King.
Carol?
my work up on the stage with the work of so many incredible directors and incredible educators and students and musicians and artists, it's overwhelming. So thank you so much. Thank you to the Connecticut High School Music Theater Awards. I really believe in the value of this organization and that we learn so much from being here every year. And every year I go home just being truly inspired by everything that you guys do. Thank you so much to the team of people that I work with. Oftentimes we say, oh, remember the good old days? And I'm aware every single day that I work at Guilford High School that these are the good old days. And Mark Gong, and my dearest collaborator and friend, Kevin Buno. Thank you to the parents in our TAPS organization and the community of Guilford that supports the arts in our public schools. We couldn't do it without the support of arts education. But I'd like to mostly thank a three-sport athlete that came to see me in Sweeney Todd in 1986. And sat there in the audience every single night and has been there every single night. And he supports my work, and that's my husband, Bill Teasdale.
Amity Regional High School.
Parents for their constant love and support of the arts. Thank you.